Mexico City's infamous La Merced neighborhood, home to hundreds of sex workers servicing the city. Many of these women are here of their own accord, but many have been trafficked from other parts of the country, tricked into the trade by men promising them love and marriage. The city is currently in the grips of a controversial crackdown by the local government, which is raiding clubs and brothels in what it claims are the rescue of trafficked women. But a local NGO recently called a meeting of sex workers to denounce the government raids. They say they're targeting sex workers who haven't been trafficked, as well as those who have been victims of trafficking rings.
Y que no se esté criminalizando la trabajadora sexual, porque hay que hacer una diferencia. Una cosa es trata y otra cosa es trabajo sexual.
She highlights a case in which a brothel was raided and two colleagues put in jail.
Ellas son trabajadoras sexuales. Ni ellas eran las encargadas del negocio, ni eran las dueñas, ni ellas explotaban a las compañeras como lo dicen.
The Mexico City crackdown is being overseen by Camila Bautista, who heads up a new prosecutor's office created earlier this year, dedicated to the investigation of human trafficking here in the city. She defended the raids and said that the nature of the cases makes investigation and prosecution hard.
La mayor barrera que cuenta con la que se encuentra la fiscalía es con el silencio de las víctimas. Las víctimas es muy complejo que hable. O sea, ellas siempre en total mutismo, en total silencio, por el terror que le tienen a su tratante, ¿verdad? O a su padrote, como le llamamos, entrecomillado. ¿Por qué? Porque, bueno, saben que las pueden golpear, inclusive hasta perder la vida, ¿no?
The challenge for the authorities is targeting the right girls. Girls like Veronica, who have been victims of traffickers. She met the father of her children in her mid-teens. She fell pregnant and moved in with him when he promised to marry her and look after her. But once she had her baby, she was forced into working as a prostitute.
Porque pues te hartas de tanto que, imagínate, son como violaciones que te están haciendo de tantos clientes, pero sí, yo sin condón, porque yo no sabía nada. Sin condón, sin nada de cuidados, y uno tras otro. Si me veía platicando con alguien que no, o sea, que no fuera cliente o alguna chava, se cruzaba del otro lado de la calle, se paraba al lado de mí y me decía, ¿quién es este güey? ¿O quién es esta culera? Y los corría, les decía, órale, camina, aquí no puedes estar.
NGOs working here estimate that thousands of women are unwittingly pulled into the sex trade each year. But trafficking victims like Veronica said many police work against them rather than with them.
Okay, imagínate, el policía, ese que te digo camina y ve quién entra y sale del hotel de los clientes. Sale el cliente y en las dos esquinas están los policías. Los agarran y se los llevan con los pretextos de que, ¿en tu casa ya saben que andas aquí? ¿Ya saben que entras con la muchacha? ¿Ya saben? Pura extorsión.
Even though Veronica escaped her captors, she stayed in the sex trade voluntarily because she has little education or access to job opportunities. The challenges facing the authorities highlight the difficulties inherent in tackling sex trafficking. Women with few options will often consider turning to prostitution, and that factor makes it harder to pinpoint and help the many women who remain trapped in sexual slavery.